The Premier of the Ndiga clan, Eria Lwasi, explained to Prime Minister Maiga how the news of the death of the late Daniel Bosa were a great shock to him since he had just departed with him. He highlighted on his last moments with the late Bosa in Chagwe, where they had gone to take part in a clan meeting.
We attended an event together with other leaders on the day he was killed. He usually has very brief speeches, but on that day, he spoke for over 30 minutes. The event was a success and we departed happily. I didn't know it was the last time I would see him.
In his message, Maiga condoled with the widow and the rest of the family, the Ndiga clan and the Buganda Kingdom in entirety for losing a great leader. Maiga eulogized the late as one who was extremely unique, humble, and asked for a clear report that details the findings about his death, bringing about the people who were involved so that they can be arraigned in courts of law. He further nullified any reports that would claim that Bosa's death is attached to clan matters. He gave assurance that the kingdom is working hand in hand with the late's family to organize a deserving send-off. The Buganda Kingdom's minister in charge of norms, culture, palaces and security, Anthony Wamala, eulogized the late as a peaceful man.
The deceased was a peaceful, kind and humble man. It's so absurd that we have lost such a great pillar of the clan.
Other people who came to condole with the family include Sara Nkole, who was working together with the late Bosa on the clan leadership, Pastor Aloysius Bujingo and Mr. Gaster Lule Ntake.
Engineer Bosa had so many achievements as a clan leader. He brought back our lost land and employed engineers from the Ndiga clan. Unfortunately, maybe some people are not happy with these achievements, and that's why we have lost him.
I ask government to regulate the use of guns in the country. Gun violence is on the rise. People should also be in position to report anyone possessing a gun publicly when not in uniform.
The Ndiga clan head Daniel Bosa was shot dead by assailants traveling on a motorcycle near his home in Lunguja, Lubaga Division, Kampala on Sunday. The family and relatives are still working through the burial arrangements. However, the police have since confirmed that the assailants were from the same clan.